In this video, I'll be using simpler terms to describe backend development and how can you get started. Whenever we talk about backend, developers start to think about this server that has been hosted somewhere on a cloud, and it has our API, it will be connected to our database. Overall, it's responsible for our business logic. If you're new to the channel, I'm DevPool. My passion is to help beginners, engineers, to succeed in the tech industry through my experience. Now back to the video. Let me give an example of when you, as a user, communicating with a backend without even knowing. When you're visiting a DevPool channel, at that moment, you're sending a request or an action to the YouTube's API. And you're sending a request saying, I would like to get all of those videos and all of its information. Cool, right? Also, why don't you communicate with API right now? Hit that subscribe and a like button. But now, where does our data come from? Well, our API, application programming interface, is connected to our database. So whenever we need to create, read, update, or delete a record, that process we call CRUD. We are making changes to our record that is stored in our database. So if you're just starting out and you're not sure where to start to practice your backend skills, build a small API application using CRUD system, because that is one of the main things that we backend developers do or should know how to do it. And here's a smaller CRUD project idea for you. Build a small API that has to do with vehicles. For example, like you'll be storing a brand name, the price, description, the release date. And for that project, you don't really have to worry about a front end, because your main objective right now is to create that CRUD system, your first CRUD system. So now you may have a question, but how do I test my API then? As backend developers, the way we actually test our API or our server code is by using tools like Insomnia or Postman. It allows us to send out requests and get a response back from the server. So if you get code 200, that means everything is good. For building out your backend application, you could use anything like Deno, Node.js, Python, PHP. It's really up to you because the list is long, so you can choose something that is best for you. And for a database, you could use something like MySQL, MongoDB, Postgres. It's really up to you, the list is long, so choose something that is best for your use case. So where does the server come in all of this? Well, once you're done building out your application on your machine, you'll have to deploy it to some hosted provider. Some examples like we have Heroku, AWS, DigitalOcean, and again, the list is long for any of those hosting providers, services. So if you're gonna do something right now that is for practice, try to go with a free service like Heroku. That is something that's really good to use at the beginning as you're starting out, so you can get familiar with how do things work and how are they connected. At this point, you have probably noticed or start to pick up that our server, our API, our database, they're all working independently from each other, which means that if, let's say today you wrote your API using Node.js and you want to change it to Deno tomorrow, well, you can do that. I mean, of course, there's going to be just small of changes you'll have to do, a little bit of code rewrite, but overall, you don't have to change your database as well as you are hosting on, let's say, Heroku or DigitalOcean, you can still host on the same server without any problems. So when it comes to learning, you can choose what you want to learn first, and then you can connect the dots. Question: do you already have a project in mind that you would like to build out first? Leave your answer in the comment below. Thanks for checking out this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.